We found this church in Green River, Utah to go to this morning. It's called Green River Bible Church.
All the way down to the land of Canaan. So that's about 600 miles, the trip that God told Abraham to take.
So the church we went to this morning was a really interesting experience. There were probably about 30 people there, and the pastor asked all the guests to stand up and introduce themselves, so I had to stand up and introduce us as being from Delaware and visiting and stuff like that. But it was actually a really cool service, and just cool to see this like small, dinky, out-of-the-way town in Utah worshiping the Lord on a Sunday. And the missionary, the pastor, we talked to him afterwards, and he was actually a missionary in Nepal for 13 years, but got kicked out of the country and came to Green River, Utah, which was his hometown, to pastor this church. So like really interesting like conversation with him, to find out he wasn't just a random country pastor. He'd like been a missionary in like Nepal of all places. So a super cool experience. So the next gas station's in 100 miles. All I can think about is a pioneer coming out here in a Conestoga wagon and just seeing this landscape and being like, what the crap did I get myself into?
This time, this is my fight song. Take that, my
bugs off our windshield. We've collected quite the assortment of bugs from across the country. What a guy.
So we're in Capitol Reef National Park, kind of just passing through, but someone at church this morning told us about Capitol Reef. There are these fruit orchards. So basically like in the 1880s, Mormon settlers came out here and planted thousands of fruit trees. So we found this apricot orchard. We asked at the visitor center about it, and they're like, oh, please, pick our fruit, because they have so many apricots. Basically, however many you eat while you're in the park is free. What you take away is $1 per pound. So in other words, we found ourselves lunch for the day. Let's go. So many apricots. And even more rotting on the ground. Go. Our first apricot. Take a bite. How's it?
It's so good.
You know, Ella just harvesting some apricots in Utah. Let's watch how she does it. Puts it on the branch, pulls down, apricots fall right in. Cha-ching.
We've been driving on Scenic Route 12 in Utah, and it's a really windy road. It's super interesting. It's been so fun to drive. We've been driving for at least an hour, probably. I think it's 100 miles, and you go through so many different sceneries. Right now, we're kind of getting back into the red rocks, but for a while, we were in the desert. We were in like regular pine tree forest. We were in alpine forest. We've seen some canyons.
We made it to Bryce. There's Ella, angry as ever. Shout out to Jake and Rachel Miller for tipping us off in this free campsite. It's about 11 minutes from Bryce, and it's pretty darn sweet. So we drove back to Bryce Canyon at about 10 p.m. to take a hike on the Queen's Garden Trail under the light of a full moon. It was suggested to us in the guidebook and by a park ranger. What do you think of it so far, Ella?
It's crazy creepy. It's like so eerie. There are lots of shadows from all the hoodoos.
Hoodoos, yeah.
They're shadows everywhere, and it's dead silent because there's
no wildlife here, at least none that makes noises. So there's just literally no noise and tons of shadows. It's really spooky.
I called it like a haunted house that God made. Because like there's nothing, it's all your imagination that's working against you with all these shadows and stuff to make you freaking creeped out. Anyway.
The sky is really beautiful.
Yeah, the stars are beautiful.
Yeah.